The Retriever Nation presents Week 6 of Life, Preparing Puppies to Go. 6.5 weeks have passed and so much has happened with both the puppies and the mama. We are at the final week. Let's first check in on the real star of this whole gig, Jasmine. Jasmine has given her puppies her all, but since they're completely weaned, her time in the pen has ceased. Her food rations, once at an all-time high of 8 cups per day, have returned to her pre-pregnancy amount, and she's now working on her physique. Enjoying her daily training and exercising sessions, she's hoping to be nicely toned up just in time for bikini season. Jeff and I have been busy behind the scenes during this last week with our puppies, preparing them to go. They had a field trip to the vet where they received their first examination, deworming regimen, and received initial immunizations. The vet commented on their confirmation, and everyone was given top marks. Back at home, they are now on dry puppy food and having quite a time with that. Our compliance rate in the litter box is almost 100%. It's remarkable to see the moment the switch goes off in their mind, and though consumed with eating or play, they suddenly stop, quickly trot over to the box to do business, and then return to the previous activity. I'm so proud of them. But there is the occasional miss that occurs. Most often this happens when they step only the front two legs in and stop. We say, almost, and still give an A for effort. There's also been the occasional pre-poopy spin ending the hiney in the wrong spot. Since all 4 feet are inside the litter pan, it's just an error in where the spin stopped. It's hard not to give an A for effort in that case either. I'm still proud of them for catching on to this so quickly. It's made my cleanup job a million times easier. These upcoming weeks are a crucial time for the puppy's brain development, as it will be when they are most curious. However, this is the same time when their natural fearfulness becomes gradually shaped by their environment. And though we've socialized them as much as possible considering the circumstances of today, it will now be left up to the new owners to take over and introduce all manner of sights, sounds, people, toys, and experiences. Fear response and hazard avoidance start early and increase rapidly, but at different times for different breeds. And knowing this approximate time will give an idea of how much work will be needed in upcoming weeks. Hazard avoidance in the wild wolf, for example, begin around 19 days old, and in the average domesticated canine around 49 days old. However, considered one of the most reactive breeds, the German Shepherd, it begins around 35 days old. On the other end of the spectrum is one of the least reactive breeds, the Labrador Retriever, where it can start as late as 72 days old. This probably contributes to the honored title of the top U.S. breed of dogs for 28 consecutive years. So, though it may be a bit early for our breed, we have begun to address the fear response to some degree. How? Well, college-age puppy snatchers often sneak up on the sleeping litter and snatch a puppy back to their bedroom. I've been told the benefits of this are threefold. It starts the puppy's early hazard avoidance desensitization. It provides needed stress therapy for the college student. And the puppies are actually receiving a college education as they've attended online classes with rave remarks from the professors. Another milestone is that the eyes have changed from blue to the beautiful browns that melt hearts. I once heard that every parent of teenagers should have a canine because at least one will be happy to see you when you come home. Those brown eyes just have a way of speaking to your soul. However, this doesn't mean they aren't mischievous little stinkers as well. Overnight, it seems, this litter has organized their own crime gang and have been busy at work the second we turn our backs. The rickrack gang of eight have vandalized, defaced property, and a few times even tried to move the entire pen off of its platform. The worst was when they left a number two plastered to the wooden wall of the litter box, somehow defying the laws of gravity. And though we haven't caught them on surveillance, we are certain it's them, as their signature calling card was left in the litter box for us to find. But then they turn back into angels again, and when they lay and turn tummy up to me, looking deep into my soul with those brown eyes blinking slowly, I'm putty in their hands and give them that tummy rub on their soft little tummy. And though I'd like things to stay like this forever, I realize it's time to disband this gang before they get the upper hand. Here's a last tribute to my puppies before the whirlwind of pickup day begins. Teal. Calm, affectionate, desires connection, mature, careful, thoughtful, intelligent. Yellow, independent, inquisitive, quick learner, intelligent, harmonious, team player, loves tummy rubs. Pink, enthusiastic, social butterfly, fearless, spitfire, fun-loving, can't give or get enough kisses, loves tummy rubs, she's just a real gem. Red, my little lumberjack bear cub, steady, confident, patient, thinker, smart, observant. Orange, intelligent, desires connection, harmonious, observant, team player, loves getting kisses and praise. Yellow lab, tough, brave, strong, thinker, observant, independent, relentless. Purple. Jeff called him little man at birth because he came out last and of the boys weighed the least, but he loved the booby and gruel so much he quickly caught up. He's now called little big man. He's observant, determined, energetic, engaged, fierce, but melts with affection and loves tummy rubs. White. Mature, attentive, intelligent, sociable, confident, strong, brave. Thanks for watching the Retriever Nation and Week 6 of Life. In just hours, they are leaving my home for good. Tune in to next week's bittersweet episode and say goodbye with me. And as always, this is Terry at the Retriever Nation.